Hey guys, welcome back to another database lesson. So in this lesson, we're going to cover the data grid view and delete query and add query for our data grid view using the local database and default data set. So with that being said, let's get rolling. Hey guys, welcome back. So before I start this tutorial, I just want to tell you that if you haven't watched my previous database tutorial, go ahead and watch that first and come back and watch this video because you might not understand some of the features that I'm going to cover in this tutorial. So with that being said, let's start our project. So right click on your application, go add new item. Go down a bit and there is our local database. Let's add that. Alright, let's add the data set also. So next and finish. So dataset has been added to our data sources. Now go over to the database explorer. Click on this little icon and right click on table, create table. Alright, just like the previous tutorial, I'm gonna be naming this users also. So the first column gonna be ID and the data type is gonna be big int. Allow null is gonna be no, unique yes, and primary key to yes. And for this one, let's put the identity to true and identity increment 1 and the identity save to 1. So that basically means that it's gonna increment that ID every time the user put that value in there. Alright, let's put another column, so username and the data types. Well, just leave the data type like that. Let's put another one, password, and let's click OK. Alright, so let's put some values inside our table. So right click on the table, go show table data. Let's put the first username admin and password. Second one to Tom, and 123456. And this one to Jerry, 111111. So yeah. So we have just created our first table. So just let's just close that and add that table to our database data set. So select our dataset, go click on this little icon and select our table and finish. Alright, so our table has been added there. Now let's create a form. Let's get a button, a level, and text box. Alright, so I'm just gonna fast forward the video and gonna arrange all this together. Alright, so as you can see, I have put two level, two text box and a button. So let's just name those. So select the first one and let's name this username underscore txt. Let's select the second one. Let's name this password underscore txt. Select the button, name this add underscore txt. And the text property, let's add this add. Alright, so we're done with this add buttons. So now let's grab a data grid view. You'll find that in database, the data components. So just drag that on our project. Resize that. Alright, so that's done. Now select our data set and click on this little icon that says edit dataset redesigner. Click on that, right click, and you'll find user table adapter. So the first default value is there is fill. So just right click and configure that. Let's see what's inside it. So as you can see, there is a query called select ID in bracket comma username comma password from users. That basically means select all those columns from our user table. So let's just go ahead and finish that. So we're gonna use this fill to fill our data grid view. So to do that, just go ahead and add a binding source to the project. So drag that and binding source, select the binding source, go over to the data source and click on this little icon, other data sources, project data source, and database data set. That's gonna put a data set there, so it's gonna link with that data set. Now select our data grid view, go over to the data source, click on this and binding source 1. So what that does, it's gonna link with the binding source, and binding source gonna link with the data set. So now in the data member of that data grid view, click on that and you will find that user table in there. So select that, so our columns is there. So if I just debug this, as you can see, all those columns are there, but there is no values. So we have to put some codes to get those values. So first, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add this user table adapter in our project. So you'll find that in user application one components in there. There is users table adapter. Just right drag that on our project, and user table adapter one has been added there. So now I'll double click on our form. Alright, so now users table adapter one dot. Now we're gonna use that query field. So there is our field query, this one, and then within the parentheses we have to fill that in with our data table, which is user table. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna type data database one data set dot user table. Alright, so now if we debug this, as you can see, it has filled with our all those values. Great. Now go back to our form, and now let's what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna double click on the add, and let's just go ahead and make a quick little query there. So right click on the user table adapter, click on add query, and use SQL statement next, and this time we're gonna use insert and next. Alright, so here it says insert into users, so insert into our users table, and then in a parenthesis it says column names, which is username and password, and the values of this username and passwords are underscore p1 and underscore p2. We're gonna replace that p1 and p2 with our text fields. So let's just click on next, and let's name this insert query and finish. Now go back to the form and let's double click on the add again. Now we're gonna call that adapter again, so user adapter one table adapter one dot, this time we're gonna use insert query, and if I use parentheses, as you can see, p1, which was in that query, so instead of p1 we're gonna use username underscore txt.txt, and comma, instead of p2 we're gonna add password underscore txt.txt. Alright, so now if we debug this, now we can add values in there. But you cannot see the values yet, just let me show you what I mean. Let's put again admin 2 and the password can be admin. Let's add that, and as you can see there is no values, but this admin has been already added there. Let me just show you again. Let's just play again, and as you can see admin 2 has been added. But why we couldn't see that time? Because we haven't updated that data grid view, so we have to do that. So how are we gonna do that? We're gonna select that user table field, and we're gonna put that query here also. So it's gonna fill again with those values. So now if we play and add another one, maybe bill and password maybe pass, and add, as you can see, now bill has been added. So alright. So next, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna make a delete button. So first select the data grid and click on this little icon there. So the first thing, I wanna disable that adding, editing, and deleting everything. Alright, so next I'm gonna add a new column. So there is three columns, ID, username, and password. So click on this little add column, and we're gonna use unbound column. Click on that, and for the name let's put delete, and for the header text let's put delete again. So header text is that username, password, ID, that text, right, which will be in the header obviously. So let's add that, and that delete text has been added there. Great. So now we have to edit that column and make it a button. Well, I forget to make it a button in there, so we have to do that. So edit column, so select the delete and go over to first go down a bit, and there is a in the design section there is column type. We have to click on that and make it a data grid view button column. So it's gonna be a button now. And when I do that, in the appearance there is another two fields called text and use column text for both for button values. So here's a text, we're gonna put delete, and then we're gonna make it true and then press OK. And now if I debug this, and as you can see all these delete buttons is here, but as you can see this this is going far from our far out of our form, so we have to fix that. So as you can see there is a little gap there from when the user grid starts, so we have to leave that blank space from there. So how are we gonna do that? Let's just select our grid view, go down to where it says header headers. There you go. Where it says row headers visible. Click on that and click on this little icon and click on false. And as you can see, this blank space is there anymore. So now let's debug this again. So yeah, now it's fitting with our grid view. That's great. But our buttons is not working. We cannot delete those values. So first, let me just show you something. As you can see, there is 1, 2, 3, 4 columns. So the index number of this column is gonna be 0, 1, 2, 3, and there is rows. So there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rows. So the first index number is gonna be the column rows. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. And there is also cell, which is this little boxes there. So these are the cells. So the cell's index number is gonna be for the first row, the cell's index number is gonna be 0, 1, 2, and 3. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna double click on this data grid view. And here I'm gonna type if e dot column index is equals to 3. Well, E is that data grid cell event argument, as I told you before. Let me just show you. Let me just debug this. Just leave that and debug this. Alright, so as I told you before, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is index number of 0, 1, 2, 3. So that's why I put there 3. So if the column index is equals 3, then let's say a message box, gonna say e dot column index. Alright, let's just go ahead and play that. And now if we click on delete, it says 3 because the column index of that is 3. Every button is gonna say the same. Yeah, so let's just leave the message box now. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna type another one, message box, and this time I'm gonna say data data grid view 1.rows, and then inside that e.rows index dot cells, and then let's say I want the first cell, which is gonna be the ID. Yeah, this one, ID. So the first cells, it's gonna give me all these values of this first cell. Let's just go ahead and debug this, and if I click on delete, and it's gonna give me an error. Great. Must have done something wrong there. But I really don't know. On command prompt, cannot be converted to string. Oh, okay. It's because we have to put a value there. So we have to put the cell value. So not the platform ID thingy. So it's coming as a string. So let's just click debug now and click delete. So 1, this one is 4, this one is 5. Yeah. So our delete button is working. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to go over to the dataset design view and right click add new query and then next, and then we're going to select the delete query and the next, and it says delete from user table where the ID is p1. So we're going to use that the index number of that ID. So we'll just click next and delete query finish. Now go over the code and let's here put users table adapter 1 dot delete query, and then we're gonna put the p1. Instead of p1, we're gonna put this value of the ID. Cut that, delete the message box, and put that there in. Alright, so let's see now. Alright, so as you already know, it's not gonna delete that. It's normally gonna delete that, but you cannot see until you fill that with the fill query. So I'm just gonna copy the fill and paste that in there again. Let's debug that. Now we can delete the query and also can add query j11111 and. So that's it for this tutorial, guys. Hope you enjoyed this. If you did, just give it a like, and if you have any questions or suggestions, comment below, and I will see you guys in the next tutorial. And make sure you click on the subscribe button and don't forget to share with your friends, families and Facebook. And make sure you click on this little bell icon that's gonna send you a message whenever I make videos in future.